Hello everyone, I am Mikhail, and this is a presentation of HeadGun, a model for one-shot neural head synthesis and editing. This work was carried out in collaboration with my PhD supervisors, Stefano Zafiriou and Victoria Sarmanska. Our proposed method can perform real-time reenactment, animating a single image with the facial expressions and head pose from a driving video.
And then I told the writer and the producer about the scenes I was envisioning, and they liked it. And then I said, well, why don't I direct it?
In addition, this is an efficient method for facial video compression and reconstruction, as each frame can be represented by 35 floating point values. HeadGun can be further used as an image editing tool, enabling us to manipulate the expressions, but also the pose, in all three rotation axes. Given a single reference or source image and the driving or target frame, we first regress around 1000 3D facial points from each one using a pre-trained retina face model. After that, we make use of these dense key points to fit an expression and identity 3D morphable model. This step yields shape and camera parameters for both images. Next, we render a 3D face representation from the parameters recovered from the reference image. In order to render the driving 3D face representation, we utilize the reference identity parameters instead, such that the 3D shape reflects the facial structure of the reference, with the expressions of the driver. This enables to overcome the identity preservation problem during reenactment. As opposed to previous one-shot talking head synthesis systems, our method can optionally take advantage of the driving audio stream and its correlation with facial and mouth movements. To that end, we extract features from the driving audio signal with deep speech model. Here, we show an overview of HeadGun. The generator consists of two subnetworks, a dense flow network and a rendering network. Given the reference image and its corresponding 3D phase representation, the dense flow network computes a flow field for warping the image and the extracted visual feature maps according to the driving 3D phase input. Then, the rendering network takes in the warped image and visual features along with the audio features and translates the 3D phase input into a photorealistic image of the source identity. The decoding part of this network is equipped with a sequence of alternating spade and adaptive instance normalization layers, which receive the visual feature maps and audio features respectively as modulation inputs. The two networks that constitute the generator are optimized end-to-end on the task of reconstruction by applying perceptual and pixel losses both on the warped and generated images. A GAN loss along with a feature matching loss further increase the photorealism of results. The semantic information provided by the 3D phase representation allows the dense flow network to learn the precise flow of the facial region, as it provides a dense correspondence of facial points between the reference and driving images. Compared to scene flow that can be obtained directly from 3D meshes, our flow field hallucinated by the dense flow network exists in areas where 3D representation is missing, such as hair and upper body. Furthermore, as 3D morphable models allow to disentangle identity from expression, our choice to condition the rendering network on the 3D face extracted from the driving person and adapt to the identity characteristics of the source enables HeadGun to tackle the identity preservation problem during reenactment. We compare our approach with four state-of-the-art methods on the problem of reconstruction or self-reenactment, where the reference identity coincides with the driving one. The results presented in the table reveal that HeadGun outperforms all four baselines by a noteworthy margin in every single metric. A visual comparison suggests that our method generates more realistic results than the baselines, with better preserved appearance traits. On the task of reenactment, HeadGun creates superior samples in terms of FID score and visual quality. Compared to the baselines, our method performs well on all three requirements of successful reenactment, that is, identity preservation as well as pose and expression transfer. Our model can also be used as an image editing tool. Given a source image and its shape and camera parameters, first, we render the corresponding 3D phase representation. Then, we adjust the expression or camera parameters manually and render a pseudo-driving 3D phase. Finally, we pass these input images through the generator to obtain a synthetic image with a novel expression or pose, reflecting the adjusted parameters. Thank you. For more, check the project website.